This represents all the water used in one year in the western United States. For the past 20 plus years, a mega drought, made worse by man-made global warming, has left the West drier than it's been in over 1,000 years. That includes the Colorado River system, where reservoirs have been depleted to record lows, which has people talking about ways to cut back.
Cities are taking aim at the backyard swimming pool.
Restrictions such as not washing cars at home and no power washing houses.
Businesses and residents must cut their outdoor watering to just one day a week.
But this is all the residential water use for 115 million people across 17 western states. All the lawn watering and toothbrushing and pools and showers use only 6% of all water consumption. The rest of this tells a totally different story. A team of researchers came up with these water use estimates, and they found that another 8% goes towards commercial and industrial uses, like offices, hotel fountains, mines, and power plants. Together with residential use, that's 14% of all water consumption in the West. All of what's left in here, the other 86%, is for growing crops.
Irrigated agriculture is the big story. All the other water users added together don't come close to irrigated agriculture.
In the dry western states, farms can't count on rain, so crops need irrigation. So here's soybeans, nuts, wheat, fruits and veggies, corn. But what's even more surprising is that the biggest share of this water goes to crops humans don't eat. The biggest water guzzler is alfalfa. You might not recognize this plant, but if you've ever seen a bale of hay that looks greenish, that's alfalfa. Unlike a lot of crops, with enough water, farmers in the West can harvest it up to 12 times a year and sell every last bit.
It's about a 9 to 10 month crop down in our part of the desert. And so you're farming it 9 or 10 months, and therefore you're irrigating it during that time.
We can group alfalfa's water with the water used for other grass hays and for corn silage. Together, this accounts for 32% of the West's entire water footprint. And what they have in common is that these are all crops grown almost exclusively to feed cows. That's more than all the residential and commercial uses combined, a third of all the water consumed in the West just for feeding cattle. Americans eat nearly 4 times more beef than the global average. Our dairy intake has been increasing for decades too, and we're not alone. At least 10% of this cattle feed ends up on container ships crossing the Pacific to feed cows in Japan, China, and the Middle East.
Agriculture in the United States is built to supply a world export market.
So what do we do about this? It's clear that letting our lawns die would make less of an impact than changing our diets. But that solution is a hard sell for consumers, even the most informed ones.
In case anybody takes me for like a meat-hating like college professor, cheeseburgers are my favorite food, and my cheeseburgers come from Colorado River water. So I have thought about it, and I think that before we all stop eating meat, we should explore a couple of other solutions.
Ben and his co-authors highlight an approach called rotational fallowing. It enables agencies representing metropolitan water users to set a price that they'll pay farmers to temporarily stop irrigating a portion of their fields. Farmers decide whether it's worth it in any given year to take that deal. And the unused water can then be sent to the cities or left in reservoirs.
Can fallowing hay and alfalfa in the Colorado River Basin solve the current 2022 year drought crisis? The answer is yes.
There's a long-term agreement like this in place between the water district that serves LA and San Diego and the Palo Verde Irrigation District in rural California. The deal allows up to 29% of the total farmland to be fallowed.
It's been largely well received in our valley. I think farmers like it.
Bart Fisher's farm depends entirely on water from the Colorado River, so he supports the conservation program. But he also says it doesn't work for everyone.
You know, whenever you do fallowing, there are economic losers and economic winners. And some of our vendors who may sell seed or fertilizer, they're a loser.
Jobs, communities, and global supply chains currently rely on Western farmers growing vast amounts of cow food in the middle of the desert. But as water supplies continue to shrink, something has to give. And how we eat, what we grow, and where we grow it.
You know, when you look at the water use on the river, the short-term savings has to come out of agriculture. There's no other place to get it.